Well, Glenn, thanks for joining us on SANFL TV. Bring us up to speed as to what's happening here at Gliderol Stadium, and particularly with the HY Spark stand in the background.
Well, the one in the background, Zach, there's not very much happening at all. Mainly because nobody can access it. The unfortunate weather event back in, when was that, early January? It's about 12 weeks ago, actually. 12 weeks ago, the roof came off, or part of the roof came off. Since then, it's been a subject of matters between council, insurance companies, engineers, and it's been a cast of thousands. The upshot of all of that is it's not available for this year. So in terms of public access, no, it can't be accessed. In terms of what's going to happen with it, it's a council-owned property. Council will make their own decision in good time.
And from the club's point of view, I guess it's really important to stress you've got a game Friday night against Port Adelaide here at Gliderol Stadium to start the SANFL Maccas League, but it'll be business as usual.
Yeah, it is. As you can see, we're standing out in the middle of the oval now, and it's arguable whether there's a ground in better condition than this. It's in fantastic order following a really hectic cricket season. And the only facility that's out of action is the grandstand, which very few people accessed anyway. So in terms of the capacity to the ground, it's business as usual. Everything else is ready.
The one major difference, obviously, is the player change rooms. Obviously, both the home and visitor teams would come change in that rooms and then also emerge out of the tunnel. Tell us about the temporary, arrangements at the time being.
Yeah, well, it's going to be a different look for people. The visitors will actually enter the ground from on the other side, from behind the scoreboard. Council have done a wonderful job refurbishing a building over there, and I think it'll be the envy of most visiting change rooms within the SANFL. May well set a new benchmark for facilities. In terms of our own, we've had a very hectic period converting the area under what was under the first floor of the original building, and we expect to get handover of that on Thursday morning. So yes, it's going to go right down to the wire, and we need everything to go right. But builders, everybody have done a great job in bringing together facilities which now will be arguably so much better than what we've ever had before.
The new facility, particularly the one under the old function centre for the Glenelg Footy Club, the players must be really excited about it because obviously, as you say, a fresh coat of paint, and there's a little bit more room than the previous ones, I'm told.
Yeah, no, they're excellent, and you'll get a chance to go through it shortly with your camera, and that'll be do its own judgment for you. But look, it's all been done with great haste, obviously, but we're hopeful that may become the permanent footprint for the footy club.
And the away change rooms, I guess the other beauty of that is they'll double as the Glenelg women's team change rooms as well moving forward.
Yeah, well, that was the motivation behind it. It was always from council's perspective about providing for women's footy, and as you're aware, we had a side in the state league competition this year. So the byproduct of that now, with this not available, is that visiting teams will also access that on an ongoing basis. So it's a bit fortuitous the way it's all turned out. So I won't use the word perfect storm because there's no such thing, but we've come out the other end of it pretty well.
And I guess, Glenn, the other side of it is players accessing the ground from the change rooms. Obviously, they'll be a little bit different to normal. They'll be sort of sectioned off with bunting and the like.
Yeah, it'll just be access to the ground a la normal community footy. There'll be some bunting for the players to access, visiting sides over near the scoreboard, ourselves. As you well know, that's a highly populated area on home matches, the southern end of the ground, for ourselves. So I'd really recommend to the players that they do very well because they'll be very close to the crowd.
And also the bar and catering facilities as normal, fans can access them as per a normal home game?
Yeah, everything's in first class shape. Yep. There's nothing we could do better than what we've got. We're really pleased with the outcome. Villies are here this year, which is a new feature at the Oval. And we're very comfortable. So we just look forward to Glenelg people coming, and certainly we'd be hopeful that some of the Port Magpies people turn up as well.
Well, Glenn, thank you very much for your time on SANFL TV, bringing us up to date with what's happening here at Gliderol Stadium and specifically with the HY Spark Stand. We wish you all the best for the big round one clash against Port Adelaide on Friday night.
Yeah, we look forward to it.